a lot of us don't have a handle on what it means to have a soul. And I've often thought about the fact that I'm walking around with an eternal entity within me. And if my soul is eternal, then I'm walking around with eternity within me. How does it change a person when they recognize that they have eternity within them? At SoulFest, we try to get people to consider the fact that everyone has a soul. You have a soul. And what are you doing to nurture your soul? How do you regard others? We're really here to talk about Matthew 25, where the master calls the flock together, divides them. There's the goats, there's the sheep. Which one am I? And he says, I was naked and you didn't clothe me, and I was homeless and you didn't bring me in. And the goats respond, when were you like that, master? I would have looked after you. And he said, which you didn't do unto the least of these, you didn't do unto me. You didn't get it. And he then turned to the sheep. He said, I was naked and you clothed me. I was hungry and you fed me. And the sheep said, when were you like that, master, that we did that? And he said, what you did unto the least of these, you did unto me. And I hear this unconsciousness of living, that the sheep weren't aware of what they were doing and the goats weren't aware of what they were doing. They were just going through life. What was it about the sheep that changed, that allowed them to stop and notice and participate in helping others? And here at SoulFest, we try to trigger that within ourselves and with everybody that's here, to get people to recognize that involuntary, that unconscious movement is available to all of us. And I think it's available through our surrendering to God's love for us. Another thing that we have at SoulFest is true love exchange wall, where we ask people to put on one side of the wall things that they have extra: refrigerators, a car, a laptop, frequent flyer miles. And then on the other side, people who have needs. I need a job, I need this, I need that. And we're trying to get people to connect and have these conversations during the festival, where they're saying, where do you live? You're from Bangor, Maine, you got a refrigerator. I'm from Hartford, Connecticut. Let's figure out how we get that refrigerator here. And relationships are born. But the haves and the have-nots, with just those small things, connect, and there's a spark that generates a deeper awareness of God's presence, God's love for us.